So I'll tell you something interesting about this book of Reisheet Chochma of Rabbi Eliyahu. It says, nice story about it, that after he passed away, so his wife had all the handwritings of her husband, and she didn't know what to do with it. For her, it wasn't, you know, she's not really able to relate what her husband wrote. So he was living in Tzfat, and she took it to the bed in Tzfat. She said, look, that's the handwritings of my husband. I don't understand anything in those things. You look and you do whatever you think is right, the right thing to do. Then. So they looked on the writings of their husband, and they said, look, we know your husband was like, you know, good rabbi, important, righteous, but it seems that he just like wrote like articles of Zohar. He just rewrote them, and he sometimes added like summary of like what's the, you know, little like sentence in the beginning and little sentence in the end. So like we don't see a reason to put an effort to print it now, because, you know, okay, whoever wants to learn Zohar will learn Zohar, you know.
He wrote some notes on the Zohar.
So then came a hand of fire from heaven on those writings, and a voice was heard. Rabbi Eliyahu Dilitash didn't only write those articles, he lived by them. He actually lived according to all of what he wrote. It's not only that he wrote again the Zohar, like pieces of Zohar. Whatever he wrote, he lived upon that. That was for him, that was his life. So therefore,
like
they
sort of
decided.
Kabbalistic Shulchan Aruch?
It's not Kabbalistic Shulchan Aruch.
For him, some life guy.
Maybe you can say like Kabbalistic Shulchan Aruch, in like introductions to life. How to live life according to the Zohar. And practically, this book of Reisheet Chochma, after it got printed, it became to be very, very accepted in among a lot of holy Jews in Am Yisrael. And I heard about the Baba Sali, that he was like reading the Reisheet Chochma, finishing, starting again. Finishing, starting again, all his life. He was going over the Reisheet Chochma all the time. Like while he was like, he was learning with someone, that one of them was resting, the other one was reading, then the other was one resting, the first one was reading, like that they were like resting, reading. Like all his life he was going through the Reisheet Chochma again and again and again. And that's a very, very holy book. So to start to get into the momentum of learning Zohar and then relating to those parts of wisdom, that it is very recommended. It is followed according to the Kabbalah of the Ramak, because Rabbi Eliyahu Dilitash was a student of the Ramak. So whoever is learning the Kabbalah of the Ramak, he will definitely find that it fits to the understanding of the Ramak in the Zohar. And okay, there's a whole another class to explain the relation between the Kabbalah of the Ramak and the Kabbalah of the Ariza. For me, there's no contradictions. It all goes together with the help of Hashem. Just have to be understood, each one for itself, and then you can see how to live life accordingly. Baruch Adonai le'olam, amen.